Thank you so much. The first piece is Falcon Fanfare by Brian Homogenes, a composer who graduated from one of the lesser schools in Virginia. Oh, wait, no, I'm just kidding. James Madison University, a very good school. He wrote that piece for a middle school band down in Georgia, and their mascot was a falcon, so hence the name Falcon Fanfare. And he wanted it to be clever and not taxing. So it has some things in there called cluster chords. It's just notes that are really close together, kind of create dissonance. So a fun piece to open the program with. The next composition is by an Australian composer, mostly known for living his life in Great Britain. Percy Grainger, he's an interesting character. His favorite instrument was the soprano saxophone. He thought there should be like 50 soprano saxophones in front of a marching band when you go out. But he did create a lot of interesting timbres and got a lot of color out of the wind band or the concert band that we have here by combining different groups together to create a new timbre or a new sound. There are many ways of thinking about music and experiencing it, and this one conjures up the term speed. It's about playing very quickly, but light and fast. It's based on an Irish reel or a dance tune, so you gotta think like fiddle playing, really fast, lots of notes. So we're gonna give our best go for Molly on the Shore by Percy Grainger. Thank you. Thank you so much. That's a very challenging word for all the players in the band. There's a lot of notes, and it's in a not so friendly key for some of the players in the band. The next tune is by an American composer named Eric Whitaker, who studied at UNLV, in Nevada, in Las Vegas, and he got his start composing for the wind ensemble there. He wrote two pieces that are famous at this point. Godzilla Eats Las Vegas, which is a very imaginative work of Godzilla strolling down the main avenue in Vegas and destroying things and like looking into a building and seeing a musical act going on. And he wrote another tune called Ghost Train, which is an imaginary, an imaging of what a locomotive sounds like, but as a tone poem, like expressed in music. So very creative work there as well. This piece is called October, which he actually wrote in October. He just sat down and started sketching, and the feeling of fall in the air, and the colors, and the mood, kind of, that's where you get the inspiration for the work. So there's a lot of dissonance in there, but beautiful dissonances. It's like a watercolor painting. The colors bleed into each other. Very expressive work. So Eric Whitaker's October. The next composition is by James Barnes, and it's called Lonely Beach, Normandy 1944. It's supposed to depict D-Day, 6-6-44. And it's called a tall poem, first of all. So he's painting a picture with musical notes. The beginning of the work is just imagining this calm stretch of beach, he describes it as, it's not necessarily a pretty piece of beach, it's just a regular old piece of sandbar. So we hear the ocean going about its day, moving back and forth on the beach. And then we hear the initial entrance of ships coming toward the beach. And he works his way through depicting the actual landing on the beach for D-Day. And has artillery and machine gun fire throughout. And then the second half of the work is a eulogy in memory of all the people who lost their lives that day. Beautiful work, very taxing, very challenging to put together in 2 days. This is James Barnes, Lonely Beach. Thank you. The next piece on the program is Sweet Land of Liberty by James Sachinsky. Jim was an arranger for the Army Field Band and bass trombonist and an arranger for the Marching Band at Virginia Tech. He was a good friend and tried to program as many of his compositions as I can as he passed away last January. So this is for Jim.
Thank you.
So in the spring, we tried to do two concerts with the concert band. So we did one at the end of February, and then this is the typical time that we do our second concert. And I was reflecting as I was planning that it's been a decade that I've been here at Concord, which is kind of hard to believe. So I thought this would be the perfect opportunity to do a big alumni event and have a bunch of people come back, like Alan here. and get to find out what everyone's been doing and see everyone, so it's been a joy. So on the stage we have our current band members, we have former band members, we have former band members that might not have graduated from Concord and gone somewhere else, we have current band directors, we have former band directors, retired band directors, and about to retire band directors, and a former professor, my colleague Tim Manley. So it's a full house, so it's a lot of fun. To get to see these guys the last few days. So I sent out most, I sent out most of this music in advance so that they would have time to look at it and listen to it, so they would be prepared for 2 days of rehearsal. We had a rehearsal last night, and we had a rehearsal this morning. So it's a lot to put together in 2 days. So I'm very proud of them and very appreciative of all their hard work. And I threw this one in as sight reading for some of them last night. So this is, I don't think it needs an introduction. This is Encanto.
One, two, three.
I need to do a quick plug for another concert that's coming up. We have a trombone choir and a tuba euphonium ensemble on campus that's open to high schoolers and alumni and current students. And we are going to do a performance on May 7th. That's the day after commencements. May 7th at 3 p.m. at University Point on campus. So we'd love to see you at that event as well. Thank you again for coming out today. We're going to close with a piece that was originally for piano, and it's my favorite Spanish march. I got to play this in high school, and it's been a fond memory for a long time. And we played this at Concord many, many moons ago. I'm not sure how long ago. It's been a while. So this is Amparita Rocco. Thank you so much for coming out today.